Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. In this video, we are going to discuss an interview question, that is, what is the difference between setVisible and setDisplay methods? And if you are thinking why we are calling as methods, not functions, then you can watch this video that is called Difference Between Method and Function. After watching this video, you will get a clear picture when we have to call a particular thing as a method or function. So let's get back to the video. First question arises in the mind, why this is an interview question? Because these methods are used to hide fields on the form, but a question is why ServiceNow is providing two methods to hide field on the form? Why it cannot be done with one method only? And that's why it becomes an interview question. So let's see the difference in this video. For the demonstration, we are going to take an example of incident form. On the incident form, there is a category field and there is a subcategory field. What we are going to do is that when the category value becomes none, then the subcategory field must be hidden from the form. So this is the example we are going to use. For this, we are going to open the incident form using the filter navigator. So in the filter navigator, we are going to write incident.form in capital. It will open the incident form in new tab. So this is our incident form. This is the category field. This is the subcategory field. When the category changes to none, then subcategory field must be hidden. For this purpose, we are going to write a client script which we have already written. So we are going to just duplicate the tab, cancel, duplicate the tab, and we are going to open the client script. Configure client script. This is the client script which we have already created, hide subcategory field. Let it open. The functionality of this client script is that it's an onChange client script which is going to run whenever the category field of incident changes. Our use case was that whenever a new value of category changes to empty, then we are going to hide the subcategory field, else we are going to make it visible. So this is the code written for that purpose. Firstly, we are going to see the setVisible method, then we are going to see the setDisplay method. Right now, as you can see, our client script is inactive, so we are going to make it active and save the client script. Our client script is saved and we are going to reload the incident form so that whatever is the client script saved get embedded into the incident. Now watch very closely what will happen when we change the category to none. Okay. So the field label and input box is hidden and there is a space left when we are using the setVisible method. Okay, and if we change the category value again, then it comes back, and we change it to none again, then it goes. Okay, so this is what setVisible method do. Now we are going to see what setDisplay method will do. Hope you get an idea what it will do. Let's see if you are correct. So we are going to go back to the client script. Now what we are going to do is that we are going to comment this line of code and we are going to uncomment this line of code, just like we are going to follow for else also. Now we are going to save the particular client script. Once the client script is saved, we are going to see what setDisplay method will do. Okay, now our client script is saved. Now we are going to reload the incident form. Watch very closely what will happen when we are going to change the category to none. Okay. Did you see what happens? Our subcategory field is hidden. Input box is hidden for subcategory field. But there is no space left. Alright, if we are going to bring it back, subcategory field is back, input box is back. Once again, we are going to change it to none. Subcategory field is hidden, input box is hidden. So that's what is the difference between setVisible and setDisplay method. So this is the difference between setVisible and setDisplay method. In setVisible, the field will be hidden, the input box will be hidden, but there will be a space left. But in setDisplay, there will be no space left. It will be used by other fields. So this is the main difference between setVisible and setDisplay methods, and that's why it is an interview question. The interviewer can also ask you that this is the functionality of setVisible. So this will behave same in mobile application and in service portal. Then the answer is no. According to the ServiceNow document, the setVisible method will work similarly to the setDisplay method, means there will be no space left behind. All the spaces will be used by other fields. So in mobile applications and service portal, setVisible method will be same as setDisplay method. So the functionality will be same. This portion of the video is very important portion of the video. In this portion of the video, we are going to see an interview question that is, we know that setVisible and setDisplay method hide the fields on the form. But how they are actually doing it? What is the cause? Or what changes they are making to that particular field? So that particular field is being hidden from the form. So we are going to see that particular answer in this portion. And this is the last portion of the video. So we are going to just quickly see it. For that, we are going to inspect the form, because everything you see on the internet is a web page, and web page is made up of HTML elements. So this form you're seeing is an HTML element. This is made up of divs, input tags, etc. All right. So one of the first thing is that the setVisible and setDisplay method is making a change to a particular element. Okay. Now we are going to see what changes they are making to that element. Firstly, we are going to see the setDisplay method, what changes it makes to a particular element. That is, in our case, the subcategory field. So we are going to just inspect this. So this is the field, and we are going to scroll up, and this is the div. As we highlight this, you can see on this which element is being highlighted particularly. So that's how we inspect the elements. We are seeing this particular div element.incident.subcategory. Now we are going to see what setDisplay make changes to that particular div. We are going to match the condition and watch very closely what will happen here. In this highlighted portion, you are going to set it category to none. Watch very closely what will happen. Did you see that? What just happened? Scroll it a bit. So firstly, there was ID, class, style. The style attribute is updated with display CSS property, and the value is none. And we can see the subcategory field is hidden from the form. So that is what setDisplay is doing. It is updating the style attribute with display CSS property with the value of none. Now, what is the use of display CSS property? The use of display CSS property is that it's going to hide the element completely from the form. It will look like that element is never present on the form. Okay, that is the purpose of using CSS display property. And that is being used by setDisplay method. Okay, now let's see what will happen when we bring back the subcategory field. Watch very closely what will happen. So we are going to just select any category and watch very closely what happens. The style attribute is again updated, and we can see that display property is being removed from here. So what setDisplay method do is that when it hides the particular field, it adds the display property in the style attribute of that particular element in which the field is contained. Okay, and when it unhide that particular field, then it removes the display CSS property from style attribute. Okay, so that's how setDisplay is working. Now we are going to see how setVisible is working. So we are going to very quickly uncomment this. Comment, uncomment this, comment. Save the client script. Reload the incident form because we want to make sure all the changes made to particular client script gets embedded into that incident form. And hence we are reloading it. Okay, now the form is being reloaded. As you can see, that subcategory field is being already highlighted. So now we are going to just match the condition and very closely see what will happen to that style attribute. Yes, it's going to make an update to an style attribute, but watch it very closely what will happen. So what happened? SetVisible method also update the style attribute with the CSS property visibility, and the value is set to hidden. What is the use of visibility CSS property? Visibility CSS property is being used to hide the elements, not hide the particular elements, but hide those elements which are contained inside that particular element. So we know that inside this element we have a label and the text box, so that particular things are hidden from the form, but the element in which the style is being updated is not hidden. So that is the use of visibility CSS property. Now watch very closely what will happen when we bring back the subcategory field. Watch very closely what will happen. The style attribute is again updated with visibility CSS property, but the value changes to visible. And we can see all the nested elements are again present on the form. So that is what setVisible method is doing. When it hides the fields, it updates the style attribute of the element with visibility CSS property with the value of hidden. Okay. And when it's unhide that particular field, it updates the element style attribute with visibility CSS property and the value is visible. So that is the main difference, or we can say that's how the setVisible and setDisplay methods works. It updates the style property of an element. Okay. And which CSS property they are going to use? SetDisplay will use the display CSS property, and setVisible will use the visibility CSS property. So this was the end of the video. And now we are completely prepared for this question in a ServiceNow interview. So we have seen what is the difference between setVisible and setDisplay methods, how these particular methods works, what changes does it make to a particular element, and what CSS properties they use to hide that particular element. If you like this video, do share the videos to others, subscribe the channel. If you have any queries, any doubts, any suggestions or any feedbacks, write that in the comment. Thank you for watching this video. Bye bye.